For the month leading up to Independence Day, starting on Thursday, January 22nd, a team pulled from multiple industries and operating throughout government will monitor participating radio stations to identify a DJ announcer and a radio station for the award of Most Patriotic. The aim is to build a sense of patriotism and nationalism ahead of independence.
Because Trinidad is having its carnival, many DJs who want to be popular are playing a lot of Trinidadian music, but what they don't realize is that literally in the next couple of months, hundreds of thousands of dollars of money will and royalties will be going to pay Marshall Montano and Bunjai and all of these people, so that at the end of it all, what's going to happen is that the St. Lucian artists will be disenfranchised in a country which is already complaining that we don't have money in the country.
Over the year, various media, including radio and television stations, have been paying large sums of money in royalties to overseas artists. The objective is to encourage DJs and stations to play more local music, thus keeping a lot of that money for local artists.
We want the DJs themselves, we believe, to learn about the different variety, whether it's people like Quavers or whether it's people like Sally or KK Elwin, the manifold of music that we have here. Also to dispel the myth that we don't have enough St. Lucian music and that the music is not of good enough quality, when you have people like Boo Hingson who have songs on charts in the States, Emran Henry's songs in charts in Hawaii, Nigeria. You have people like Mecca getting songs accepted into sitcoms, but yet down here we can't get the airplay.
The competition runs for a month. All stations will be considered, according to Christopher Hunt. Two cash prizes of $1,000 each will be presented to the radio station and the DJ. For the DBS News World, I am Cecile Actille.